You ready, viewers? Today we're getting into a sensitive topic, one that may leave you a little uncomfortable. If you can't handle it, plug your ears and wait until it's over. Here we go. Urine. There, I said it. While the word has been a topic of many jokes since your childhood, we assure you that it's no laughing matter. In today's video, we're going to be talking about health conditions that are indicated through urine. From hyperglycemia to pregnancy to lupus, we're talking all that and more. Number 1. Hyperglycemia. Whoa, we're starting off with a fancy word here. Let's back up for a second. Hyperglycemia is simply the medical term for high blood sugar or glucose. It affects people who suffer from diabetes. For those who are unaware they may have hyperglycemia, frequent urination will usually serve as the first warning sign. The condition of frequent urination is also known as polyuria. In this case, frequent is classified by 3 or more liters of urine per day. With a healthy human being, the kidneys will go through their normal process of reabsorbing sugar into the bloodstream before making urine. If you have hyperglycemia, there's too much sugar to be reabsorbed, resulting in an excess amount to appear in your urine. In a study from the late 90s, researchers focused on a 69-year-old man who suffered from diabetes. Due to his hyperglycemia, his body maintained a steady state of polyuria for 40 hours. So if you find yourself urinating at an alarming frequency, hyperglycemia is a strong possibility. Number 2. Pregnancy. Frequent urination during pregnancy is normal. While it's experienced during all 3 trimesters, the first is certainly the most crucial. When a woman is pregnant, her urinary system goes through many changes. The pregnancy hormones stimulate the kidneys. From here, they expand to produce more urine than usual. This is why when someone doesn't realize they're pregnant, one of the first signs is polyuria. But it can get much scarier than that. In some cases, the frequent urination is a symptom of diabetes insipidus, also known as DI. This is a condition in which a person not only uses the bathroom more than usual, but also feels much thirstier. Studies have shown that it can complicate 1 in every 30,000 pregnancies. If you're pregnant and have concerns, it's probably best to consult a doctor. Number 3. Kidney disease. This is among the most alarming entries on our list. If blood is found in your urine, it can be a sign of kidney disease. The blood will turn your urine into the colors of red, pink, or brown. This symptom is also known as hematuria. Hematuria has several causes. These include infections in the bladder and prostate, as well as hepatitis. If you have an enlarged prostate or suffer from urinary stones, hematuria is likely to be a warning sign. In this particular case, it's your kidneys that need treatment. When the kidneys are healthy, they're usually strong enough to hold in blood cells. When the kidneys have been damaged, these cells begin to leak into the urine. But blood is not the only noticeable flag. You may notice strange bubbles in the liquid as well. This actually is a protein from your system that has also leaked into your urine and taken the form of foam. We know, it sounds terrifying, doesn't it? But this is just another thing that your urine can tell you about your health. Make sure you consult a healthcare professional for your urinalysis. We're about halfway through already. Before we continue, are you concerned about your overall health? Our channel is loaded with tons of informative content. Check out our clip of 7 symptoms that can be mistaken for other diseases. Have you been getting the right amount of protein? Click on our clip of signs you may have a protein deficiency. Now, back to our list of things urine can tell you about your health. Number 4. Lupus. Warning signs of this condition can also appear in your urine. Lupus is an autoimmune disease in which your immune system begins to attack your tissues. There currently is no cure. Before being diagnosed, you may notice signs in the form of fatigue, fever, hair loss, and swollen lymph nodes. But damaged urine is not far behind. In the last few minutes, we've discussed urinary malfunction in the form of either frequent, bloody, or foamy urine. With lupus, all 3 are possible. Especially with lupus nephritis, the type of lupus where the kidney's nephrons become inflamed. As a result, the kidneys are unable to properly remove waste from the body. Your waste level will gradually begin to build up. If this goes untreated, your kidneys face permanent damage. Experts state that 60% of lupus patients will be diagnosed with this type. If a lupus patient experiences burning while urinating, this could point towards a urinary tract infection. With this being the case, a doctor may prescribe you with antibiotics. Nevertheless, patients with lupus nephritis are recommended to make changes to their lifestyle in order to protect their kidneys. This includes cutting sodium and cholesterol, avoiding alcohol and cigarettes, and adopting regular exercise routines. Number 5. Dehydration. It's almost ironic that the lack of fluids in your system causes you to urinate even more. Well, that's exactly the case with dehydration. When your body's becoming dehydrated, you begin to lose fluid, placing pressure on your kidneys to urinate. Other symptoms can include dry mouth, dizziness, and vomiting. People who are severely dehydrated can lose between 10 to 15% of their body's water. When going to the bathroom, you'll notice that your urine is much darker than usual. This is your fluid leaving the body. Clear, healthy urine is much clearer, as you're receiving the proper amount of water. A question has lingered in the medical world as to whether or not the color of your urine is determined by something known as urine osmolality, the measure of urine concentration. In 2017, a study was conducted in China where researchers collected urine samples from 68 men. Through examination, they concluded that the color of the urine was indeed related to osmolality, and the quantity is a reliable way to measure your hydration. Number 6. Gallbladder issues. Many of us only become familiar with our gallbladder after our grandmother has it removed. The gallbladder is a tiny organ resting just below our liver. Its job is to squeeze bile into the intestines in order to digest fat. Keep in mind, this is not an organ that's necessary to your survival, hence your grandmother getting it removed. If you're having gallbladder problems, one of the first signs can be darker urine. This can sometimes indicate gallstones, an obstruction in the duct that sends bile to your intestines. Now, before you begin to worry about a possible problem, don't. There are plenty of other treatments that can help you with your gallstones. Known as the gallbladder diet, medical experts recommend a reduction in carbohydrates as well as an increase in the consumption of high-fiber foods. While you're partaking in this diet, make sure you're losing weight at a reasonable pace. Too much weight too quickly can result in your stones becoming larger. Number 7. Sleep apnea. This is one that may surprise you. Frequent trips to the bathroom can actually be a sign of sleep apnea. Obstructive sleep apnea, or OSA, is a condition where you stop breathing for periods of time while asleep. While abnormal urination habits have been linked, the relation is not yet understood. A 2009 study focused on the urination habits of men who had been suffering from sleep apnea. They concluded that OSA was associated with an overactive bladder. Number 8. Anxiety. This entry may surprise you even more than the last. While frequent urination can be a sign of poor physical health, it can also be a warning sign that your mental health is deteriorating. Generalized anxiety disorder affects an estimated 6.8 million people in the United States, and this is just those who have been diagnosed. Also referred to as GAD, generalized anxiety disorder is when your primary symptom is one of being anxious. To put it simply, anxiety and other forms of mental stress can increase your need to urinate. While the reason for this is not confirmed 100%, scientists theorize that it evokes our fight-or-flight instinct. When we think we're in harm's way, our brain reacts as a sort of detector. When the detector goes off, our body begins to react in a way for us to survive. If we're scared, it's much easier to flee when we've gone to the bathroom. This translates into anxiety as well. When we're anxious, we feel the need to urinate sometimes immediately after going. If you're having increased feelings of anxiety, feel free to reach out to a doctor or a trusted family member. Have you been noticing changes in your urine? Did you find this video helpful? Let us know in the comment section below. We'd love to hear from you.
Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait, what kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.